Australia's last international hit out was earlier this year against Torpedo Moscow. A two-match series with the Socceroos triumphant in the second game at Olympic Park by 3-0. Several younger players were given their first chance to impress in the green and gold, and they didn't disappoint. This time around, the Socceroos faced stiff opposition in Hajduk Split, who finished third in the recently completed Yugoslavian First Division, and they also qualified for the Cup Final.
Superstars! The type of thrills and spills you, the fans, want to see and hear. Return to splendour with Crop and Roll Inferno!
And a fairly healthy crowd here at Parramatta Stadium in Sydney. The Australian team line up a new look side from the one that played in the World Cup qualifiers. Only four players in that original side from there. But there's a couple of youngsters we should look out for, in particular the goalkeeper from Adelaide City, Robert Zabica. He has a chance to establish himself in the first 11. Zabica and John Phelan are the keepers tonight, but Zabica played in the last game Australia played against Torpedo Moscow, a 3-0 victory in Melbourne. The other youngster to look out for, a man who's been resurrected in the international side of things, is Ernie Tapai, the 23-year-old Sunshine George Cross midfielder, and he's making his sixth appearance. His debut was against the Yugoslav side back in 1988, Dinamo Zagreb. So Australia only having played two games this year, a loss to Torpedo Moscow and a victory in the second game in Melbourne. Hajduk Split, on the other hand, come to Sydney after finishing third in the Yugoslavian First Division, and only recently they lost the Cup Final to Red Star Belgrade 1-0. That goal was scored by Darko Pančev. But either way, it's a formidable lineup indeed, although two players are with the Yugoslavian side preparing for the World Cup Finals. But two we should look out for is Joško Jelicic and Goran Vucevic. Goran Vucevic is a very, very handy player, and he operates as the playmaker in this Hajduk Split side. A lot to be expected tonight. And there's the Australian bench, and we'll wait now for the kickoff. And Sydney referee Gary Powell gets us underway for this match between the Socceroos and Hajduk Split. And only one side of the stadium open here to the public in Sydney at Parramatta Stadium, and that's well packed, I can tell you. A very boisterous crowd as we look into the Ken Thornett stand. First long ball for Graham Arnold. He heads it back. Speculative shot. Not a bad one. A goal. That's a goal for Paul Trimboli. Unbelievable start for the Socceroos. 33 seconds in. The youngster Paul Trimboli breaks the deadlock with his first touch. This player is a player to look out for. Brayden couldn't stop that, a dipping, vicious drive. And the South Melbourne striker Paul Trimboli, you wouldn't have expected it really. What a beautiful shot.
Absolutely brilliant, absolutely world-class goal. Unbelievable shot.
And Trimboli, that's his fourth goal in five appearances, but he gave that some stick and the keeper had no chance. Australia leading by 1-0. At the back, Bernal across to Jankos. And the switch to Van Egmond. And a foul, the referee has pulled up play. So Hajduk splits. This time under a bit more pressure at the back. And another infringement by Jurkovic. Referee Gary Power getting Lalic back the 10 metres. Here it comes, a curler. The keeper's out. Didn't get to it properly. There's another chance. Infringement, though. Offside it is. Graham Arnold caught offside, and Rally Rasic, already deficiencies in this Hajduk Split defence.
It's interesting. The team which played in the Cup Final only 2 weeks ago that can have so many defensive misunderstandings. But I think the credit goes to Australians. Australians know that they can cause many problems to Arnold's height and ability in the air.
Lalić. And Hajduk haven't really crowded as much as we would have expected in the midfield, but it's happening at the moment. Vucevic, touch on Mikic, and cleared away by Van Egmond. They're starting to piece together some good moves. Hajduk split. Hadži Abdić inside to Bilic. And the switch again back to Hadži Abdić. He did extremely well to keep that in. And he gets inside of Jelecki. He gets the cross in, back post ball. Free header. Free header for Jelicic. Not enough power, and again misdirected. And Joško Jelicic, only 19 years of age in the Yugoslav under 23 side. No trouble at all for Robert Zabica. Clearance headed back, in fact, by Stimac. And Tapai was on the way through, and the referee, Gary Power, is having a word to Jurkovic. And yet another free kick rally. It's been a bit of a stop-start first half.
Australian team looks very well composed. They are very aggressive and they take no nonsense at the present time. And since kick-off, they are just in control of the game. I don't think so. It's only goal because we scored in the 33rd second. But for a mature team as I do, time to settle down. You see, that's
really and again Trimboli rally.
Another chance. The Hajduk defense just cannot settle down. Every time Australians cross the ball, they are just completely confused.
Here it is. Here the first time, ball inside. Graham Arnold was up there involved, unselfishly chested down, and Trimboli shooting over the top. And the Ken Fournette stand is full tonight to see Eddie Thompson's Socceroos take on Hajduk Split. Here's the foul by Jelecki. And this time was Jelicic. Was that accidental thing that happened there with Trimboli? He ran into Trimboli. There was no malice from Paul Trimboli. Jelicic is all right at the moment. Here was that incident again. Well, now the clip, Jelicic, and he'd run into Trimboli, but free kick now. Australia haven't cleared it away as yet. McCulloch is there, Van Egmond. And now Arnold. Arnold couldn't get through Lalić. Hadži Abdić has made the run of the right. Here it is for Hadži Abdić. First time ball. Hadži Abdić gets the return pass. Still going on with it. Mikic is back there, involved earlier on. And is it a chance? And just over the top. The first opportunity for Hajduk Split. Hadži Abdić, Mikic. And in the end, Jelicic involved. And as the fans behind the Hajduk Split goal get excited, this was good work from Hadži Abdić, Mikic. And it's the corner reflection of Judge there. And now Zabica, no trouble at all. And here's another angle, lovely backheeler rally.
Typical European football, 1-2. Good finishing, could have been surprised with a goal, but didn't result that Australians are still well composed. Hajduk, this is first attack in 20 minutes of the game.
And this time the foul is against Hadži Abdić. And Hajduk split with the first Yugoslavian team to tour Australia back in 1949, and that was an unbelievable tour rally.
That's a team of great tradition and a team which is always playing a beautiful type of football. Even with the absence of few superstars, they are still a good team, but you can't discredit the Australian team.
And there's that incident down that far side, but Hajduk Split, as I was saying, 21 matches in 49, they only lost one game. They beat the Socceroos then. They weren't called the Socceroos, but they beat them 6 out of 7 games. This time around, the Socceroos are leading by 1-0. But Hajduk are starting to work their way back into this game after a very slow and tentative start. Hadži Abdić is at a busy game now. There's a chance there, and Miljko Mikic, who played against Australia back in Seoul at the Olympic Games, he just couldn't get his foot to it. He was waiting in the wings so long. Just about a place in the team, and this time
Arnold is winning so well in the air, and every time Tapai and Julewski gets the ball, and I think this is where danger comes. I haven't seen so much involvement by McCulloch and Wright as much as these two youngsters. If McCulloch and Wright gets much more involved, I'm sure the result would probably favour Australians much more, because in defence we are really playing well.
In particular, I've been impressed with our aerial strength as Lalic.
So far, Arnold has won every ball in the air, and Australian midfielders and Trimboli must benefit from it.
Now the corner kick to come in on that far side. Right over the top. And just in case you're wondering why there isn't any crowd in the Mick Cronin stand, it's because they've only been allowed to come into the Ken Thornett stand on the commentary side of the field. Full house on this side of the pitch. And conservative estimates, I would think, around the 10,000 mark. 29 minutes in. Australia 1, Hajduk Split 0. A long throw for Arnold, and Arnold was held by Slaven Bilic, the stopper. There was no doubts about that.
As I pointed before, Andy, they are taking notice of Arnold at the present time. They won't allow him to operate any longer. And the more Arnold gets involved, probably he will cause more problems in their defence.
Here comes the free kick from Tobin. Not a very good header away. Trimboli's there. And picking up the pieces is Misha. And he just stumbled. Just thinking about the back middle, which would have been dangerous because Arnold was looming like a vulture. Ante Misha, the midfielder, goes back to help his defence. It looks like the Julewski long throw. There it is. Tobin got the header on. Trimboli is there. He shoots on target. And just wide. He's always exciting every time he gets possession in that sort of situation, Paul Trimboli.
That's what football is about, clinical finishing and taking opportunity. Young Trimboli is just a highly talented player.
It's back with Stimats. And Michel. He was clipped by Julewski, and he wasn't happy with that. And Julewski goes into the book. Now, I don't think the Socceroos have played in a spiteful manner, except I do admit that Van Egmond challenge was a pretty late one.
Yeah, Julewski just being naive. This is inexperience. He didn't have to collect yellow card at this point of time.
But if you notice, it looked like he was being held onto as well.
Yeah, absolutely unnecessary. It's a good challenge, but he is just behind the ball.
Okay, the wall is up at the moment. The wall is up. Vucevic shots, fielding over. Eddie Thompson smiles. He doesn't look too concerned. But here it is, not a bad effort. Just curling over the top. And Zabika had it covered. Well worth the effort from that sort of range. Charlie Yankos at the back. We've had just over 37 minutes of play. Tapo couldn't get through on Jurkovic as the ball is cleared out. Van Egmond just knocking it down the line. McCulloch trying to squeeze it through for Tapo, headed away by Jurkin. And Vucevic couldn't keep that in. Quick throw. Wade has knocked it on for Arnold, who's onside. Graham Arnold, the Socceroo, just shooting wide. Arnold was onside when the ball was played. The Hajduk players aren't too impressed with that decision. But when we look at it on replay, Rally, I think you'll find that, well, we don't get to see when the pass was made there, which does deceive the viewers at home.
I wouldn't like to argue this one. It's a very dicey situation. I think Arnold did the right thing to play on. It's very difficult from this angle to comment. Definitely, linesman was very hesitant in making decision.
But here's the ball from Wade again on replay.
Again, unnecessary foul.
And while that was happening, Andrew Bernal went in the book, the yellow card. So we've had four yellows, which...
He has been so positive so far, Bernal. He's playing well. It's just not necessary to do. I think it's being naive.
I just hope that that sort of trend doesn't continue. We've had three yellow cards in the last 15 minutes. And this time Alex Togan, who I don't think he's got a mean streak in him at all.
Australians don't have to do it. They are playing well enough. They are not under pressure, and there is no need for this yellow card. This is only going to restrict them to play over 90 minutes to the fullest potential.
So Lalić on the ball. Mladen Lalić, junior player, right through the ranks at Hajduk Split. That's a lovely free kick, by the way, and headed away by Graham Arnold. Hasn't lost a header all night. Knocked inside by Vucevic. Half-heartedly cleared by Toden. The shot this time wide by Lalić. But Hajduk Split are starting to show us that they're fighting their way back into this game.
Only way for them, Andy, to break through the Australian defence is either a dead ball or stretching their play on the flanks. They haven't done as yet. Every time they stretch on the flank, they're causing a bit of concern.
And now Arnold. Socceroos have the numbers. The flag's up against Tommy McCulloch. The referee's allowed play to continue. But McCulloch was the man offside. Now Hajduk Split, this is a good decision by the referee.
Excellent decision by the referee.
And Misha trying to thread his way through. There's the overlapping. Jurkovic knocked back inside. And Nikic couldn't get on the end of it. Still the pressure on. Jabdic getting the ball across. Confusion. Claims of handballs. A brilliant save. Jelicic was the man. Jelicic turning and Zabika diving low. There were claims of handball. But this was a chance that I think Hajduk should have taken. There's the ball inside. Looked like a handball, but perhaps accidental. The shot, Zabika down quickly.
Excellent save by the goalkeeper. Exceptional.
In comes the corner, near post. And Tapai is the man to deny Lalić. But Hajduk, Jelicic having the best chance for them in the 42nd minute. Can they create something again before half-time? Jurkin. Cross to Stimac. He has a shot and dipping one, and Zabika was right behind it. Just composing his defence. And now Tobin gets the ball away to the intended man, who was a Trimbali, but now with a strong header. And again, Gary Van Edwin down the line, Wade getting it through for Tapai, but Tapai couldn't do much. Stimac was back for Hajduk Split. And that's a good challenge. The Socceroos winning possession again. Jalewski. Jalewski, a body check. Mili Hadjiabic, and he gets the yellow. So, well, the yellow cards have been coming out.
If we continue with yellow cards, it's like the game will become yellow soon.
That's five yellow cards.
Yeah, that wasn't necessary, really, because it's just ordinary foul, nothing.
This is possibly the last chance for the Socceroos to add to their 33rd second goal. McCulloch looking for Wade or Arnold. And this time, Hajduk defence get the ball away. and Van Egmond is the man who concedes the foul. So the Socceroos, I would think, Rally would be content with this score. And there is the half-time whistle from Gary Power.
It's very, very good 45 minutes on behalf of the Socceroos. I'm very, very impressed with the defensive pattern, and especially Zabika, who hasn't had so much to do, but he's so confident and so cocky. It's just pleasure to watch the goalkeeper performing so well.
So just quickly to sum up, Paul Trimboli broke the deadlock after just 33 seconds of play with a scorching, dipping shot. And from there on, it was end-to-end football. 1-0 it is. Here's Mike Tomalaris on the sideline.
Thank you very much, Andy. Well, one man who has placed a special interest in the Hajduk split side is Sydney Croatia coach Tony Vrizhna. Tony, I believe one or two players from the Hajduk split side could be gracing the red, white and blue of Sydney Croatia next summer.
Yeah, we're hoping definitely two of them, that's Hadži Abdić and Setinov. They want to come here and we would be very pleased to have them.
Tony, you're a little bit unhappy about the strip the Hajduk split players are wearing tonight.
Yeah, they have a problem in the dressing room before they start. That's why they start nervous. They want to change the jerseys. They didn't want to start playing with the red star. Management didn't like to change anything. So they went on a park with a tracksuit on and they tear off the red star right on a park. And I don't know what will happen after that.
A political decision, obviously.
Well, it's a political decision because of the political changes in Croatia. The boys were very happy to play without the red star, and they will probably have a meeting after that, but I'm pleased they did that.
What about the game? Hajduk appeared shell-shocked after Paul Trimboli scored that great goal.
Yes, they were shocked, as I said, with all those things going on in the dressing room. They caught them by surprise. I think that's a great goal, simply because it came from nowhere, but I think from then on it was all Hajduk, and I think they will win the game at the end. They play very good.
Okay, thanks very much, Tony. All right, we'll have the full second half highlights straight after this break.
So there's the start of the second half. The referee Gary Power getting us underway, and it's Hajduk split running from the right to the left-hand side of the screens. White shirts and blue shorts. And at the moment, they're a goal down. Paul Trimboli was the man who broke the deadlock, and it didn't take him too long. 33 seconds. Both sides have had numerous chances to add a few more goals. As Gary Van Egmond is back, take the throw in for Trimboli. On the first infringement, we had quite a few in the first half. Five yellow cards were handed out. Van Egmond, he was aiming for Arnold, no trouble at all for the Hajduk defence. Jelicic found it a bit difficult to control. The flag stays down because Hadži Abdić kept him on, but this time Paul Wade is offside. Jalewski had knocked the ball through. Wade was caught offside. Hadži Abdić takes the throw. And the switch across to the left-hand side where Damir Jurković, 20-year-old left back, has lost possession though. Arnold, the touch on for Trimboli, but Wade had possession and he was trying to switch it through for Tapa, who was well in the clear. No trouble at all for him. Hajduk did well to recover. Vucevic. Vucevic across now to Marin Lalic. Lalic and Van Egmond. And Van Egmond clearing the ball away. Corner kick for Hajduk split. 2 minutes of play in the second half. The visiting Hajduk trail. Here's how that corner came about. And then we got there first. There's the corner. Zabika fisting it away. Strong fist out. Relieve the pressure. Halic has taken the throw. Mihic was held back by Bernal, and he's already got a yellow card. Right in front of the referee, Gary Power. There's that infringement. Now the free kick by Lalic. There was an interesting one, and Zabika was lucky because at that near post, Misha was there. All it needed was a touch rally.
Very lucky, very unusual free kick, typical professional.
The wall really didn't protect Zabika's goal, but luckily for Zabika and the Socceroos, went straight to him. Enough to clear the ball away. That's not a bad clearance though. Hajduk doing well at the moment. Jurkan Tapai was pressuring and he blatant foul though. Quickly taken free kick. Hajabdic. The runner's coming from Misha, but it's gone inside for Vucevic. And Bernal clearing it. Tapai. And Tapai was clipped, but he was in the clear. Jurkovic goes into the book. But Lally, I would have played the advantage rule here.
Well, certainly you would. I think that's a sensible decision because Tapai is just got away, and that could cause another problem. Probably could result in another goal.
And that's probably what Eddie's thinking there on the bench, that Tapai should have been allowed to play on.
Absolutely right. Player can be cautioned even after the incident.
Now Jalewski, Hajabdic was the man. It's been an interesting tussle between those two players. George Jalewski gives away 9 years to Hajabdic, who's got a good reputation. And now it looks like a bit of a problem on the sideline. Referee Gary Powell is coming across to check with his officials, because I think what you'll find, remember earlier on in the first half, Jurkovic, I picked him as the player booked. Now he's going to check here because there was a confusion between, I think in that incident it was
number five,
Jurkovic and Jurkan. Now the referee has waved play on, but I thought Jurkovic was the man who was given the yellow, because it appeared at the time that he pointed to Jurkovic. And that's probably what they're talking about. Now Trimboli back for Jalewski. McCulloch's come up now. Jalewski's turning, squeezing it through. He's onside. No, he's off. He did well to finish, but the flag was up straight away. And Trimboli, as ever, deadly in that area. There's the finishing from Paul Trimboli. Judged offside. And Jalewski did extremely well to turn and squeeze it through. And while this is going on, Jankos knocking it back to Zabika. There's going to be some substitutions. Gurkica Kovac will be the player that will come on. There's Gurkica Kovac, 24-year-old defender. Coming on, it looks like number 11, Mihic. And a long clearance by Zabika. Jurkovic had kept the Australians onside. All his teammates ran out except for Jurkovic. That's why they didn't appeal for the offside. And now Mihic is the man coming off. Kovac is coming on. 14 minutes into the second half, the first change of the match. Mirko Mihic is the man who's coming off. Ninth minute of the match, Australia still leading by 1-0. And Mirko Mihic, who played against the Socceroos in Seoul at the Olympic Games, he comes off. And Gurkica Kovac is the man who comes on. Kovac will go straight back and assume a defensive position as the Socceroo free kick is ready. Tapai and McCulloch. Tapai's made the run. McCulloch hesitates momentarily, and now he knocks it in. Wade's there at the back post and pushing by Paul Wade. And it was just thrown out. The referee was right there. It's got to be put on the ground, then cleared away. And there's the clearance now. Another change. and Tony Krislovic. Here's the man who's stretching on the sideline there, the St George marksman. There's Jelicic. He's being tagged by Van Egmond, and good work by Gary Van Egmond. Stimac across, finding Bilic. He's got a few options. The first one there was Kovac. He'd be happy to get his first touch, but it wasn't a very good first touch to play. And the change is to be made. The goal scorer, Paul Trimboli, is the man who's going to come off. And Tony Krislovic is coming on. Surprise change, would you think, Rally?
Very much so. Every time Paul touched the ball, it caused a problem. He scored an incredible goal. He dipped in a doubtful offside situation. Second time, second attempt, few good shots. And I think what Eddie is looking really to close the game and keep result as it stands.
So Eddie Thompson, the man in charge of the Socceroos for this two-match series, he'll be pleased with the contribution of Trimboli. As Zabika now is looking for some more options. It might be the throw it is this time. He doesn't decide to get the ball upfield. Tapai, he's got a bit of space, time to control. He does. Wade, the return ball. Van Egmond read it, but so did Djurković for Hajduk Split. Lalic now inside, not a bad ball, headed back for Stimac. But Jankos is there, he won't play it back. Two players were behind him, he would have been called up. There's a nice ball for Van Egmond, who did extremely well to control that. And he's tried to knock it inside for Krislovic. Now Kovac, that ball went to no one except for Zabika.
It's a very good understanding between Van Egmond and Tapai. Obviously, they play the Footscray together and they know each other so well.
Now, Jankos. Van Egmond. Tapai loses out to that chance. It was a good one by Jurković. Yerken. Nikola Yerken. That was well done by Jurković. Knocks it inside. Jelicic, again the switch across, Kovac looking for Jelicic, that was just too much, too far forward. So there's the view from behind the Australian goal as Zabika, again another big clearance and it results in an Australian throw-in. Was headed backwards by Jurković. And again, it looks like another change will be made very soon. It is. Lalic, Mladen Lalic is coming off. And Dejan Racunista is coming on. Dejan Racunista is the man who comes on. The second change for Hajduk. Van Egmond, the short throw inside. Tapai. He's trying to find Krislovic. I should say McCulloch, who's made the run. Tapai pushing. Right in front. The linesman, as Tapai comes back to help his defence. Tapai hasn't held back in his challenges tonight. Now Stimac. Helping his midfield create something. As a deep ball is knocked in. Yamal was away. Put it on. Racunista light up for Jurković. And it was always going wide. Swinging away from the goal. It's the first time we've really seen Jurković move forward and have an attempted goal.
I think that's a sign of desperation too, Andy, because I think Tapai has caused so many problems to him and that he will have probably nightmares after this match.
And Bilic has played it to Radjavic, but he loses out. Jalewski, Krislovic is onside at the moment. He should knock it to him. He's gone and solo here. This isn't a bad little run, but he won't get away from Radjavic. Jalewski, I think, should have just knocked it sooner to Krislovic. He was in a very good position at one stage there. But that would have been a great effort if he went all the way with it. But now, at the other end, Jelicic. Tagged by Van Egmond, Jelicic. His distribution just hasn't been there. He's had a couple of chances to knock the ball inside, but it hasn't worked. That wasn't a very good effort, Rally.
As much as the longer the game progresses, I think Hajduk is getting into that state of desperation, and they have, even great players are making such fundamental errors.
It's Hajduk split with Misha squeezing it to the right. Ball aimed inside for Jelicic, but again Australia can counter, but there's only Kristovic up there. Arnold finding Jean-Paul de Marini. It's been knocked on for Kristovic, but Nikola Jurkin hasn't had trouble at all. Slaven Bilic and for Raciunista. Back again, Stimats. Attack breaking down as Tobin was there, and then Jankos just clearing it out of the ground virtually, you would think.
If we still have two front runners, Arnold and Kuzlovic, I think we would be far more effective. Hajduk is not pressurizing, no need to go and pack defense.
Now it's Stimats. It's not a bad ball at all. Crossing the left is Bilic, knocking it inside. Jankos heads it away. Jean-Paul de Marini was involved in a challenge with Kovac. And now it's just hoiked away by Tapai. Just only 11 minutes of play left in this first half. It's not including stoppages. Hadži Abdić, the long ball, a searching ball for Jelicic. And we saw a similar thing happen in the first half. They just couldn't get onto the end of it again. As Jankos knocks it right, Van Egmond. It's Jankos again. Zabika will go for the long clearance. Side flags up against Kristovic.
It would be a shame if you get caught on such a long ball and surprised. This is the second time, one in the first half, and exactly the same through the center of defense.
Now Duke splits. We perhaps were expecting a bit more from them in the second half as Van Egmond knocks it back to Bernal. Can turn back to Zabika. Jankos again. Just playing for time as you would expect, leading 1-0. Now Bernal. Switch across to Tobin. Time running out now, really, for Hajduk split. Less than 10 minutes left. There's the ball for Wade. Brilliant clears it away. Straight to Van Egmond. He's knocked it on. Wade's onside, and he's knocked it back behind Tapai. Australia might have been able to start something there.
I would say players are getting physically tired, so on the mental side, you're starting to suffer too. I think they're also getting a bit excited. The game is 1-0, and they are just worrying about everything, whatever goes against them.
The flag up against Misha. On the right-hand side of the Hajduk formation. Jankos comes out. Kristovic is making the run. There's the ball aimed this time, though, for Tapai. Tapai and Jurkovic. And Tapai is the man there. Jurkin, I think, was claiming for handball, but in fact he has been ruled to have committed the foul. And it looked like he did push him out of the way there, Ali.
Yeah. Definitely. It was probably from both players.
So McCulloch's playing it inside to Van Egmond, and he's given the ball away. Hajduk Split again presented with something here. Jelicic, the numbers came back for Australia. Graham Arnold again coming back to help his defence. This time Van Ekman with clearance, Krislovic. Krislovic was adjudged to foul the Dutch Mister. Quickly taken free kick, Kovac.
As you can see, Australian team with full 11 players defending.
The man who took the shot there was Haji Abdic. No worries at all for Robert Zabica. Australia leading 1-0 in this first game of Hajduk Split's tour. As Kovac put in the challenge, he's really tried hard since he's come on, as has Rajunista, squeezing it to the right-hand side. And then there was no foul there, the referee waved play on. Krislovic has got it inside for McCulloch. Now Arnold. Arnold looking for Van Egmond. Van Egmond and Jurkan. And Van Egmond will take the throw. Wade is coming up, Krislovic is in there, McCulloch is also there. There's the Socceroo bench. And our victory is within grasp. Just over 6 minutes of normal time left. The throw-in, knocked back by Wade. Van Egmond's cross, Krislovic went down. And it was cleared away. And Krislovic claimed he was fouled by Bilic.
That was one of the better crosses by Van Egmond.
So Tapai is coming across for the corner kick.
I one wonders where does he get the energy really at this time of the year. He has done so much over 90 minutes. It's just absolutely unbelievable.
Arnold was at the near post. Easily headed away. Not many players up there, the Socceroos at all. They're not really content to push home this advantage that they have. Happy with the 1-0 result at this stage.
I think that's a logical decision, and this is international match as far as they are concerned. And why should they pay the price on so many occasions? Why should we? That's if Hajduk wants to change the game, that's up to them to come up and challenge.
Slaven Bilic. Jurkovic. Started the second half strongly, Jurkovic, but we haven't seen much of him in attack. Now it's Graham Arnold for the Socceroos. Turns. Tapai is forward. Too far for Tapai though. Now Bilic. Haji Abdic, Stimats, Misha, and there's Jurkovic. He's coming forward. Rare occasion recently. That's not a bad looking cross. And the header by Kovac. Didn't really test out Zabica, but for one moment there, it looked like something might have come out of that.
I don't think so. They would deserve Andy, because just ordinary cross through the center of defense, and providing that the defender provides a challenge, cannot result in a goal. No way.
Three and a half minutes of normal time left. The score is 1-0, and young Marconi midfielder Paul Ocon looks like he might come on. His first taste of Socceroo football. Bloody his clearance is headed away by Gary Van Egmond. And there is the change. Ernie Tapai, the man who's done so much running tonight. He's coming off. And another youngster, Paul Ocon. Good job by Tapai.
In my book, simply man of the match. So much effort, so much contribution. That's just pleasure.
And this time the cross by Jelicic, again Zabika was there.
He's enjoying his game. I think he's absolutely outstanding. It's just faultless football.
Any bit of danger he's had has really been in the air, and he's done so well. Huge clearance, and all the way to Gloria. He throws it out for Bilic. Time is really running out now. 2 minutes of normal. And now here's Rajanista. He's looking for support. Jurkovic could have cut him through as Jokos cleared the ball away. Rajanista goes down. Jelicic. And it comes off Bernal. And everyone back to the Socceroos, including Bernal. Kovac will take the corner kick. And here comes Zabika fisting it away. Adjabdic. And now Vucevic. Flag stays down. The shot, Zabika with a brilliant save. Right down, he made it look so easy.
A bit of luck in it, and it's the right time and the right spot. He's having such a wonderful evening that whatever he touches, it just turns to goal.
And it's ironic that Bilic, the defender, came up for that. Here he is, Slaven Bilic, showing what his striker should be doing. Krstović was pushed in the back there. Yerken. Socceroos just content to buy time. Just on 30 seconds of normal time left. Some smiling faces, I should say, on the Socceroo bench.
They have every reason to smile, Andy. They were not inferior in any aspect of the game. Hajduk looks a bit more polished from time to time, but still. You know, we are competing quite well with it.
So, the last chance perhaps. Bernal hooks it away, but there's Socceroo players there in support. McCulloch finding Wade. And he just knocks it down into that far corner. In terms of time wasting, not a bad little tactic. Luka Berezovic. Concerned, as you would expect. His team's down a goal. They're playing stoppages at the moment. Stimats. And it went over the top of Jekic's head. And Tobin Luckin was there. Quite what a deceptive bounce.
Bit of misunderstanding between two players from the same club.
Misha. Cross inside. Misha still trying to start something. McCulloch is there. It's Babic. Inside Vucevic. Return ball. Jean-Paul Demary gets it back. There's a foul by Misha. There's no reason for that, but order is restored. And Jean-Paul Demary looked up there to knock it back to his goalkeeper. And he was taken out by Misha. And that's where I would have probably given a yellow card for that sort of challenge, but nonetheless, injury time, 1.5 minutes of that so far. Australia leading by 1-0 against Hajduk Split. And it's Graham Arnold. 4-4 at the moment. The ball inside. Krstović's shot on the turn. Good play by the two Socceroo strikers. Krstović knows that Arnold did extremely well. It was a good ball inside. Krstović might have considered trying to control that, but the first time shot over the top, and that's the last bit of play. The Socceroos have defeated Hajduk Split in the first of two matches here at Parramatta Stadium by 1-0, and Rally Rasic, a pretty good start for the Socceroos in this two-match series.
Very, very good start. An excellent performance by the defence. Back five played very well. Tapai, absolutely incredible work rate. In my book, man of the match, simple the best. And As I said, we competed with them in every aspect of the game, and we were not inferior, and it shows that we can do and beat European sides just as equally as they can probably come over here and dominate us as it happened before.
So Australia continuing that trend, they beat Yugoslavia 1-0 at the Seoul Olympics, and here's Michael Tomalaris on the sideline with Socceroo caretaker coach Eddie Thompson.
Well, Eddie Thompson's initiation as national coach, albeit as caretaker coach, has come with excellent results. Congratulations, Eddie. The boys played well.
Yeah, they've done really well. Some of them have not had a game now for about a month, so Hadjic's a very good team, so I'm real happy with the result.
Who are the players in particular of the new crop that you've implemented and played well?
I think Bernal had a great game at the back. I thought Ernie Tapai done really well, but it's difficult to hand it on us. Charlie Yankos has been under a lot of pressure, but me dropping him, Charlie had a great game tonight.
There was a lot of hostility creeping into the match as well.
Yeah, I think that once they could see that they weren't going to have an easy game and the game was getting out of their grasp, they started to do a wee bit of kicking, but we weren't the innocent ourselves.
So Melbourne now and Hadjic will be a lot fresher, a lot fitter and a lot keener, I guess.
Well, I hope not anyway, you know, but a real benefit from the game as well. But Hadjic's a very good team. We've done exceptionally well to hold them, and I thought Zabika was excellent there the second half.
All right, thank you, Eddie. A good result for Australia, a good result for Eddie.